Since 2010, expansion of tea activities increased as part of the president's poverty eradication campaign, and this led to the development of the tea strategy to expand tea production, processing, and marketing within the old and new growing areas through the provision of tea seedlings and advisory services. Years down the road, and having registered a number of contributions to the country's economic development, the government has revealed that the sector has been hit by a crisis.
There is a drop in effective demand of tea. And for those of you who probably come from tea growing areas or who are conversant with the tea industry, there is a crisis in the tea industry. In areas like Chigezi, Paso, Akore, Toro, where we grow a lot of tea, the prices have come down.
Due to various setbacks, including fall in tea prices plus foreign wars in Sudan and Ukraine, some farmers and tea factories have quit tea farming and processing ventures, respectively. This has inevitably sparked a need to establish a tea auction market in Uganda, which will be partly physical but largely electronic.
Tea is auctioned in Mombasa. We have also taken a decision to establish a tea auction here in Kampala. And we have already arranged our experts in the government to study what it takes for us to have a tea market auctioning done here in Kampala instead of Mombasa. And that will also help in facilitating and supporting the tea industry.
Introduced into the country in the 1990s and later becoming a major cash crop, Uganda has over 21,000 hectares of land that is being used for tea growing, and this includes both private and government tea growing. Following the farmers' outcries and the existent drop in tea demand, the government has stepped forward with a number of intermediaries to curb down the situation and encourage continuous tea growing in the country.
We have therefore taken a decision to establish a fertilizer revolving fund, which will initially be capitalized by government and will provide a subsidy. So we are going to buy fertilizer and provide a subsidy, distribute it, working with the tea processing factories, so that the fertilizer is given to the farmers, and that is going to support farmers, especially in addressing issues.
In the cabinet sitting, it was further agreed that 20 billion shillings be allocated for the fertilizer revolving fund. Also, the cabinet directed the Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries to come up with a policy that will spell out a number of measures to guide and ably revamp the tea sector. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.